We meet together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all people. And we say together, most merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we confess that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have done. Help us to amend what we are, and direct what we shall be, that we may do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with you, our God. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Of the Lord as she knew, and the child was young.
They would return to Eli and said, "Oh my Lord, as you live, my Lord, I am the woman who is standing in your presence, praying to the Lord. For this child, I pray, and the Lord has granted me the petition that I made to him. Therefore, I led him to the Lord. As long as he lives, he is given to the Lord." She left him there for the Lord. This is the word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
By God's grace, may I speak in his name, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Folks, today is Mothering Sunday, and just to begin with, I wondered if our young people could help me out just one more time along with our readings. I want to ask you one rather deep question, and my deep question for you is, when you think of what qualities you need to be a great mother, what sort of things do you think of? When you think about what does it mean to be a great mother, what sort of things do you think you need as a person? What characteristics? What do you need to be a great mother? So this is my deep question for you. Any thoughts? Period.
To take care of your child.
To take care of your child. That's a lovely answer and very accurate. Any more thoughts? A few bowed heads. That's fine. Any more thoughts? Ah, fantastic. Thank you. What does it take to be a great mother? Be kind. That's a lovely answer. I'm going to open this up to our adults. So my deep question for you is, along with kindness and taking care of your child, what other qualities does it take to be a great mother? Any adult who's willing to speak. Qualities it takes to be a great mother. Father,
Patience.
Thank you, Father Dirk.
Unconditional love.
Lovely answer. Unconditional love. Perry, the last word.
Good cooking.
Good cooking. Okay, Perry. Well done. Good cooking. Okay. So we have good cooking, unconditional love, patience, kindness, and taking care of your child. I think that's pretty good.
Great stuff, everybody.
Folks, particularly for the younger members of our church, I want to tell you a tiny bit about the background to this day. We call it Mothering Sunday. There is a phrase out there which is also Mother's Day. But when we do it in church, we stress it as Mothering Sunday. Tiny bit of history. In this country, it was the day when people were encouraged to go back to the church where they were baptized. And I just want to take a pause there. If you could hold in your mind, if you know this answer, the place where you were baptized, just recall in your mind, where were you baptized? And maybe just think to yourself, who took you to that point? You may have done it as an adult, in which case the answer is you did, but it might be a parent or a friend who encouraged you. I just wondered if, I'm going to ask that to you very quickly, to tell us where he was baptized. One of our adults is going to tell us. Jen, do you know where you were baptized?
As in my church in Jamaica, Pentecostal church.
Fantastic. Jen baptized in Pentecostal church in Jamaica, and Gazi baptized in Nigeria. Just hold that in your mind. This was the day when you went back to the place where you were baptized. In this country, it was also a day off for people who'd gone away from home to work. So if you were an apprentice, which means that you were going to learn a trade somewhere else, you got a day off because you might have gone far away and you went back home. If you were in service, which means that if you were working, maybe cleaning or looking after somebody's house, this was the day when you were released to go back to the town you came from.
And the one last thing on the sort of history front I was going to tell you is that it's a day we're all encouraged to remember our cathedral, which in this case in London is St. Paul's. And that was because the cathedral was the mother church of all these smaller parish churches. So we're a parish church, and we look to St. Paul's as our mother church. And I'm just going to show you one very quick thing behind Father Bell's head. In our church, the only place we have an image is in this icon. This is an icon of St. Paul, and he's carrying a Bible, and on the top there, he's carrying St. Paul's Cathedral. And you might never have noticed that, but there it is, our mother church, in a picture in our own church. So, very quick recap. It was a day to go back to the place where you were baptized. It was the day to remember your mother church, the cathedral. It was a day where if you were far from home, you went back home. That was a special thing to do on Mothering Sunday. Every Sunday, either myself or Father Doug or Sharma gives a sermon. And our job is to try and bring alive for you the readings from the Bible of that day. And I want to say two very quick things about our readings. The first reading was the one that Perry read for us so beautifully. It's a reading about Samuel. And we always have to ask ourselves, why does that get set on this day? And the reason is that Samuel was almost like a miracle child. He was the son of Hannah. And Hannah thought that she couldn't have children. And she was told, quite late in life, you will have a child, and he'll be a really special child. And that is Samuel. And Samuel is important because for a long time, Israel didn't have a king. They had different sorts of rulers. And Samuel was the last great ruler before Israel had a king, which was David. So Samuel is a really special figure in the Bible. And he's like a king, he's also like a priest. But the reason we get him today is that Hannah thought that she would never have a child. And then suddenly along comes Samuel. And her response is, I'm going to give this child to God, because I never thought I would have a child. So I'm going to dedicate his life to God. And that's why we get Samuel read today. The reading which Adrian read for us so brilliantly is about Jesus coming into the temple. He's really young then, and he comes in with Mary and Joseph, and he meets somebody in the temple called Simeon. And Simeon sees this young couple coming in, and he knows, somehow he just knows, that this is the Messiah, this is God's Son. And he says, this child is going to be a light for all people. And then Simeon also says to Mary, this is a very special child, but it's also a child that will cause you some pain, because he knows somehow that Jesus' life is not going to be easy. And so it's a very special story in the Bible, and it's about a young couple coming in with a child, and it's about an old man who's been saying his prayers all his life, and somehow he just knows that this is God's Son. Father God, I think you'll agree with me, the last challenge of the preacher is, what connection can you make to your own life in these readings? And that's the really key thing. It's all very well listening to a reading, but the real challenge is, what's the connection with my life? And so I want to give you just one thought for each. What's the It's a really special thing. And you are unbelievably special to your parents. And you probably don't even know how special you are, but you are deeply special to your parents. And that's what Hannah knew when Samuel was born. And what's the connection with our lives about the other one? I think the connection is that it's a miracle that God could have a son. Because when we think about God, there's so much we don't know about God. And I think it's actually quite important to remember that. There's a lot we don't know. But there are some things we really do know. And the thing we know most of all is that God chose to become one of us. God chose to walk this earth in Jesus. And if we want to know about God, our best way of knowing about God is to learn the story of Jesus' life, because that's the story that's most similar to who we are. We're human, Jesus is fully human and fully God. So I think it's a lovely thing to remember Jesus being born today, and Jesus lived in a family just as we do. Very last thing. Sometimes in church, people get told off for talking about Mother's Day when they should be talking about Mothering Sunday. I think we can hold the two together. I think it is a day to give thanks for our own mothers. I think it's very proper that we should do that today. So today we give thanks for our mothers. My mum is sitting in the church today, so I'd like to say thank you to her. So I think it's a good day to say that. But it's also a day to remember Mother Church. And the link, I think, is that we have our own family, but we also have the church family. And one doesn't take away from the other, but they go side by side. We have our own family, and we also have this group of people who are also our family. And for me, I think both are really wonderful things to celebrate. So today we give thanks to the mothers of our church, we give thanks to Mother Church, and I give thanks for all the young people of our church who have helped us out today. Amen. We believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Sit for our prayers.
Gracious Father, on this Mothering Sunday, we give thanks for giving you.
privilege of having children to bring up. Sometimes we feel unprepared, anxious, with this huge responsibility when feeling overwhelmed. Help us to understand we could not be asked to do anything more important than to love, guide, and nurture a new life. In doing this, we share the divine activity, loving, guiding, and nurturing the whole human race. And we pray with Mary, my soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God, I say. Lord, hear us. We pray for mothers everywhere. Young mothers bored by the responsibility, old mothers thrilled that a child has been born. Mothers who are single, scared and lonely. Mothers in Somalia, there's been no rain for 5 years now. All suffering from malnutrition and mental violence. Medical care, and often their babies die from malnutrition. And we think of mothers in Ukraine, where children see and feel terrible suffering, and mothers are helpless in the onset of war. We think of bitter ones born in Turkey and Syria, life as they knew it has disappeared. Men long for normality, and we all long for peace, quality of life, and justice for every family, all over our world. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
And Father, we pray for fathers everywhere, young fathers unsure how to be a father, and husband, fathers in poorer countries wondering how they're going to feed another child. Fathers in our world, leaving home early and coming home too late to enjoy their special times. Lord, bless all fathers, guide them, give them wisdom and the ability to love and care for their families. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously.
Lord, be with mothers and fathers who have these children. Birthdays and Christmas, Lord, are really difficult. And the sense of loss of our mighty Queen never goes away. And we think of them in the church there, especially. And the pain and the hurt, the disappointment, may we see that it's always present. And Father, we thank you for aunties, uncles, grandparents, childminders, and godparents who contribute a great deal to children. And we have members and extended family. We know that your experience of family life carries on into the next generation. Be among those to bless, guide, and keep safe in special unions of love, patience, and forgiveness. And we will continue to teach us the way of Jesus who knew the security of a loving family. Mary and Joseph in Nazareth. Lord, bless our church families here in St. John of Jerusalem. And we thank you for our clergy, Andrew, Charlotte, and Philip. Lord, and send these prayers.
Save us,
your Son,
our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Jesus said, whoever does the will of God is my brother and sister and mother. As we have opportunity, let us work for the good of all, especially for the members of the household of faith. The peace of the Lord be always with you. We offer one another a sign of God's peace. We sing together our offertory hymn, which is number 377.
Thank you.
earth has given and human hands have made, become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to set before you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, become for us the cup of salvation. Blessed be God forever. If you'd like to follow the Eucharistic prayer, we're going to use prayer G, which is on page 28, page 280.
Great is the mystery of faith.
and we rejoice that he intercedes for us at your right hand. Pour out your Holy Spirit as we bring before you the gifts of your creation. May they be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. As we eat and drink these holy things in your presence, form us in the likeness of Christ and build us into a living temple to your glory. Bring us at the last, with John the Baptist and all the saints, to the vision of that eternal splendor for which you have created us. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honor and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen. Please sit down. To the remember your holy cross, swords and bodies, to be a living sacrifice. Set us up to the power of your Spirit, to live and work with your grace and glory. Amen. Again, just to welcome anyone who's visiting with us this morning, and do stay behind for tea and coffee if you have time. To remind you that after every Sunday service, there will be people to pray with me or offer prayers for healing in the side chapel just behind where the organ is played. If you'd like to pray with somebody or talk with somebody, please make your way there after the service. There's evening prayer today here at 4 o'clock. On Tuesday, the 21st, there's a talk in the cathedral by a man called John Barton, who's very scholarly about the Bible. If you'd like to and have time to make your way to the cathedral, you're really welcome. And there's tickets and information on their website. We're doing Lent study with some of our neighbouring churches of different denominations. And last week was at Hampton Chapel, just down the road. This week is at a neighbouring Anglican church, just at St. Michael and All Angels, London Fields, just the other side of London Fields. You'd be really welcome there, and that's at 7:30 on Wednesday. Our annual church meeting is next Sunday, which is Lent 5, and immediately after the service, we have our meeting, which doesn't take long, so please stay behind if you have time. One important thing is that every 3 years, people who've been on the council for 3 years, they stand down for a year and then can come back if they'd like to. So there's always a rolling cycle of parish council membership. There will be 5 people standing down this year, and if there are people here who would like to think about joining the council, please have a word with myself or with Liz and William or wardens or anyone you know is on the parish council to have a word with us. But we would love you to come forward. So looking for 5 new people. I've had one very kind offer already, and there are 4 more, so please have a think about that. And we're also going to be electing on Deanery Synod Reps, which there are 2. So please just give that some thought. On Easter morning, we have a tradition of people buying lilies, or often for people who've died, and if that's something you'd like to do, please just sign up at the sheet at the back of church. I'm just going to have a look at me to see whether she'd like to give out the Messiah message or whether I should. There is a wonderful Come and Sing Messiah, and the idea with that is that it's rehearsing Messiah and singing it all in a single day. And it's going to be on the 15th of April. There's a way of booking tickets, singers and audience, on Eventbrite. And I know that there's also a need for singers and helpers all during the day and in the evening. So if that's a day you can manage, either as a singer or as a helper, please have a word with and some of us are on the horizon now, and there is an organizing meeting on Palm Sunday, which is the 2nd of April, just after church. If you'd like to join in organizing, please have a word with Liz and Helen, and you'd be really welcome for that meeting on Palm Sunday. I'm going to leave you to read all the other many notices, just to double check whether there are any other notices we should be keeping out, or indeed any other
be clandestine birthday week. During this last hymn, I was going to ask a favour of our young people. We have four buckets of flowers here to be distributed. If you're willing, I need four young people who are willing to carry a bucket around the church and whiz around and give out flowers. Could you just raise your hand if you'd be willing? I'm just going to double check. Athena could be a helper. I remember Athena on helper duty. Could we have four people? One, two here, three from Chantel. Just need one more. Fantastic. Gabriella. I've got about four. If I can invite you to come to the front now, that would be great. And I'm just going to point out where these buckets are. They're just hiding behind the columns on each side. There are two on this side, there are two on that side. Athena can also help out. That would be brilliant. And anyone else, Alexander as well. These can go to, I think we have enough to go to everyone. Maybe if you start with the women of the church, because that would be shocking if they didn't get one. And then you can spread around after that. It has come up with in prayers already. I am very aware that on this day, there are mixed devotions for lots of people, for all sorts of reasons that I can think of. I think the one thing that maybe could unite us all, even in the midst of difficulty, is that this is a celebration of love. It's a celebration of the love of God for all people. And so if this is a hard day, maybe that's a good day to focus on. It's a celebration of the love of God for all of us. And I'd like to invite you to stand for our final hymn, which is number 497.
Be with us as we continue to grow in the grace of God.
knowledge of our Lord and Saviour, to whom be glory now and for all eternity, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you this day and evermore. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.
Thank you.